Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Monday of the 30th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice. Turn to the Lord in His strength. Constantly seek His face.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command so that we may merit what you promise. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another, as God has forgiven you in Christ. Be imitators of God, as beloved children, and live in love, as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma. Immorality or any impurity or greed must not even be mentioned among you, as is fitting among holy ones. No obscenity or silly or suggestive talk, which is out of place, but instead thanksgiving. Be sure of this, that no immoral or impure or greedy person, that is, an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no one deceive you with empty arguments, for because of these things the wrath of God is coming upon the disobedient. So do not be associated with them. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Behave like God as His very dear children.
Behave like God as His very dear children.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on His law day and night.
Behave like God as His very dear children.
He is like a tree planted near running water, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers.
Behave like God as His very dear children.
Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff, which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Behave like God as His very dear children.
Alleluia, Alleluia. Your word, O Lord, is truth. Consecrate us in the truth. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus was teaching in a synagogue on the Sabbath, and a woman was there who for 18 years had been crippled by a spirit. She was bent over, completely incapable of standing erect. When Jesus saw her, he called to her and said, "Woman, you are set free of your infirmity." He laid his hands on her, and she at once stood up and glorified God. But the leader of the synagogue, indignant that Jesus had cured on a Sabbath, said to the crowd in reply, "There are 6 days when work should be done. Come on those days to be cured, not on the Sabbath." The Lord said to him in reply, "Hypocrites, does not each one of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his ass from the manger and lead it out for watering? This daughter of Abraham, whom Satan had bound for 18 years now, ought she not to have been set free on the Sabbath day from this bondage?" When he said this, all his adversaries were humiliated, and the whole crowd rejoiced at all the splendid deeds done by him. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Here you have a very classic clash between Jesus and the religious authorities, no? Remember the very first charge against Jesus before claiming to be the Son of God is his violation of the Sabbath day rule, no? So this is really the most basic and fundamental issue against him by the religious authorities. So that is the context of our reflections for today, no? Tandaan natin na ito yung kauna-unahang issue kung saan nagbanggaan yung mga pinuno ng relihiyon ng panahon na yon at ang Panginoong Hesukristo, no? Yung paglabag ng Panginoon sa araw ng Sabat, no? The first point that I invite you to reflect on is that this is the classic struggle, no? As it is the first struggle between Christ and the religious authorities, but to this day, this is the classic struggle. Remember when Pope Francis became Pope in 2013, this is one of the first messages that he delivered. He said, we must be less dogmatic. Again, let me repeat, hindi niya sinabing, we must not follow dogma, throw dogma out of the window. No, he did not say that. But he said, we should become more pastoral. No? We should become more pastoral, proclaiming God's mercy. And this is the same conflict now in the gospel for today. So 2,000 years ago, this is already a big issue. No? And then the second point that we will reflect on is that, again, the tremendous compassion of Christ. It's interesting that if you notice, the woman who was suffering for 18 years, no, she did not come to Christ. No, she did not ask. No, but the Lord was very sensitive already to what she needed and what she was going through. No, so that again, going back to that compassion of Christ. No, and then the third and last point is to see the reaction of the crowd and the religious authorities. The crowd cheered Christ, no? How great his deeds were. And most especially after the Lord responded to the accusation of the religious authorities, all the more the crowd cheered him. No? And then the Pharisees, of course, the reaction was that they're very angry. They're very, very angry and wanted to really to bring this issue, no, to against Christ to a head. Okay, the first point, no? The first point about the classic conflict, no? Again, tandaan natin na yan ang matagal nang tunggalian hanggang ngayon, no? Yung mga legalistic na tao sa simbahan at yung mga tao naman na malakas ang pastoral sense, ano? Ang importante ay ang balanse, no? Kasi the question here, do we follow the letter of the law or the spirit of the law? Do we follow the strict dogmatic rules of the church, or do we also consider the pastoral needs of the people? In fact, the Pope, remember, one of the images that he used was that the church now is like a field hospital, no? Out in the world, no? There's that battle going on, and the church has become like, no, a field hospital, bringing healing to people. I think that is very important for us to reflect on, because we ourselves need to make a choice. I'll go back to that later on. Pero mahalaga na piliin natin ano ba talaga ang higit na magpapakita ng pagmamahal at ng pagkalinga ng Diyos sa atin lahat. And then the second point is, again, the example of Christ, no, the compassion of Christ, how he is able to enter the interior, no, the interior movements of a person. As I said, this woman did not beg or did not scream for help, but the Lord sense, no, her need, that she was in bondage for 18 years. No? She was being held captive or prisoner of Satan, no, because, and gave her that infirmity. And the Lord very, very clearly, no, senses that and heals her. And even his answer to the religious authorities was very, very clear. If you take care of your animals, even on the Sabbath, give them the basic need of drinking water, all what the more a human person, no? I think that is also very important point to reflect on, no? That we can be kind to our pets, to our animals, and yet for the people who are suffering in front of us, again, what is our response, no? That is the same situation here. Pareho yan ng sitwasyon, ano? Na ano ba ang ating pagtugon dito sa mga nangangailangan sa ating kapaligiran, no? At hindi lamang tayo na nakukulong, no, sa ating mga immediate na pamilya, bahay, ang household o yung katrabaho natin, pero tumingin din sa paligid, no, sa populasyon na maraming dinaraanan na pagdurusa, no. The second point to reflect on, no, that to develop a sense of compassion for everybody, for especially for the suffering people around us, no, which now leads us to the last point, no, just comparing the reaction of the religious authorities and the crowds, no. I think we must ask ourselves, where are we also, no, in that spectrum? The religious authorities who condemned, no, what the compassionate, merciful act of Christ because of the letter of the law and because of being very legalistic and very rigid, no? And they could not get out of their narrow comfort zones, no? Or the crowd, no, which cheered Jesus on, no? But also, again, just a footnote and very important for us to reflect on. Remember, it is this same crowd later on that would shout, no, crucify him, no, we want Barabbas, no? And I think it's good for us to reflect on this, because when you think about it, while it is true that there's a part of us that is the same as the religious authorities, but I think majority of our inner self would be the same as the crowd. But then again, remember the parable of the sower and the seed, that they are rejoicing now, but later on, no, a few years down the road, they will ask the religious authorities and even Pilate to crucify Christ. The parable of the sower and the seed reminds us that have we accepted it and interiorized it, and therefore it becomes a conviction in our lives. And let me end by again going back, no, to that point that ang ating buhay may tawag, Father Ferriols, our philosophy teacher, the late Father Ferriols used to remind and always tell us, may tawag ng mahalaga. And in that tawag ng mahalaga is the moral imperative. The moral imperative for us to change the world that is filled with structural injustices, the bad distribution of material resources. And because of that, people suffer. And because of that also, the people are able to hold on not just to material resources, but to power, and then it becomes a vicious cycle. So ano yung tawag ng mahalaga sa pagkakataon natin ngayon? Sana ay pagnilayan natin ito. What is the moral imperative of our time? Yes, in our country, but also all around us, globally. What is that moral imperative that we as Christians must respond to and live out in our lives? Let us continue our Mass, and let us continue to reflect on these points as we continue our Mass and prayer. The better we know God, the more we realize our total dependence on Him. Aware of our limitations, we pray in our helplessness to God the Father.
That the leaders of the Church may give their lives totally in the service of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have the generosity of heart to break through our self-preoccupation and try to reach out to others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may see in the poor and those who suffer the face of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together now, let us offer our prayer for our nation. Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng 1,000 may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan, kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate His death. With living faith we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father most holy, and accept all the prayers offered for our intentions offered for our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who helped see us through the challenges the pandemic brought. Those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffer the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady of Help of All Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Rock,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now offer our prayer for peace, joy, and hope for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name, and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace, joy, and hope that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, won for us. For all those affected by calamities, natural and man-made. For all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time. Amen. Our Lady, Mother of God and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. Have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Siguro ho mga bandang baka sa Miyerkules, kung hindi bukas sa Miyerkules, we will give you the email address that you can send the names of your departed loved ones, your relatives and friends for the month of November. Remember, November is the month of all souls. So we will pray for them. We will remember them at every Mass as we did last year. So we'll begin to request you to send us those names. Kindly give the full name. Best if you give us the baptismal name. No, for example, Jose Caluag or Carmelo Caluag. So that it's always nice to use the baptismal name praying for our departed loved ones. Maraming pong salamat. Have a good day. Have a good week ahead. Thank you.
We all can share to send these children and youth to school. For only 3,000 pesos a month, let a child from the most vulnerable communities finish elementary, junior, and senior high school. For only 4,000 pesos per month, give a dropout or an out-of-school youth a better shot at finding a stable job. Caritas Philippines appeals for your kindness, generosity, and compassion. This is our Caritas promise, that we will leave no one behind.